Okay, now we're live. Now we're on YouTube Studio. Apparently, Facebook was muting me after I started talking about whatnot and this, that, and the other. All of a sudden, the microphone started. And I know that it should be good. So we'll see how this works out. I have a whole lot more faith in YouTube than I do Facebook. So now back to where I have to start all over, because I had to delete the other live video from Facebook. All 14 minutes of it. And I know what I was talking about, so it won't take me much to refresh my memory. Trust me. Now then, May 21st, 2021. Live and direct. Here from just outside Doha Hollow, near Honey Run, Honeyville, but 2.5 miles from Stanley, if you need to know. I haven't even had the news on, so I don't know what's going on with the country, the president, whatnot, Israel. It's so discouraging. I haven't had it on. Anyway, my disguise here, as I'm going to say what it is, as many of you have ever saw the movie Cool Hand Luke with Paul Newman, Strother Martin, George Kennedy, and Dennis Hopper's in there as well, among didn't have a name. He's just called the man with no eyes, Morgan. His last name Morgan. Anyway, that guy, I can't remember his name. He played in a lot of movies, and he played the part of the, I guess he was the head honcho. Strother Martin was the warden. But I have a rant here. A family member, close family member, and a lifelong friend of 55 plus years. I took it upon myself yesterday, after numerous other times of doing this and doing that, taking where it needed to go, Walmart, wherever, to the store. So yesterday, I told my wife, I said, you know, this Ninja grill we have, I said, it makes a good hot dog. I'm going to fix my buddies up with a nice meal, make some homemade chili, put on the hot dogs, put them on a paper plate, wrapped them up with aluminum foil, took them to Luray, stopped it. Sharper's Value, got a bag of chicken, a soda and some chips, a couple candy bars. I said, they're all set. So before I get to any further on that, Strother Martin in the movie, his main part in the movie came when he said, what we have here is failure to communicate. That's a big one. I would like to add, and I'm sure Strother Martin, if he was here, wouldn't mind, or Warner Brothers or whoever else for that matter, but what we have here is failure to appreciate. And he also said, if he wants it, he gets it. Apparently, that's the way they want it. So if they want it that way, I guess that's the way they're going to end up. You can only help somebody so many times before you say, what the hell's you? I'm wasting gas. I'm wasting valuable time away from my wife and my family, my daughters, my grandsons, my granddaughters. Why? Why waste time? Time is precious. Now more than ever, at any point in time in history, time is precious. So, I'm to the point where I said, I'm done, pretty much done. Yeah. But you only take advantage of me so many times before I said, you know, I'm like an old dog. You can just keep on and on and on. So I'm just about laying back down here like this before I really respond and say anything. Well, I'm ready to respond. And I'm saying, sorry about your luck. Yeah, that's what I was told yesterday. Oh, well, sorry about your luck. My luck is pretty good compared to theirs, I'll tell you. Sorry about your luck. Boy, that struck a nerve. Never even acknowledged that I had brought a meal there. It was too occupied with other activity, if you know what I mean. Oh, we were in a tour. We're starving, apparently, until I got there. Before I got there. But when I get there, because of some people that were there, I'm being kind of using that word, people, they didn't have time to eat. They were no longer hungry for food. You know, I really don't know much about drug addiction. I've never had that problem. Thank you, Lord. I know you have to reach out and help some people, but how many times do you have to reach out? How many times do you have to continually sacrifice something in your own life to help somebody that won't even help yourself? Will somebody please tell me that? So in good spirit and good natural Christian belief, I am going to attempt, along with my son-in-law, to take these individuals a Bible. I don't know if it'll do any good, because we're pretty much beyond the breaking point here. That was a long, long time ago. The breaking point was way back. Now we're just trying to throw out a lifeline to keep them from completely drowning. Trying to bring maybe their salvation. Maybe they'll see at least... I'm sorry, folks. This really disturbing to me. After I went out of the way, I told my wife, I said, you were right. I was wasting my time, my money, my gas. I never saw nothing like this coming in this point in time. In our county. I know it's bad in the cities, but it's bad. It's just bad. It's everywhere. This is a pandemic. Because if you start registering people that are affected, people that are under influence, people that are dying, it's in the top five. I bet on that. It's in the top five deaths. It's got to be. Got to be. Very, very discouraging. You don't even know your own grandchildren's names. don't even know them, don't get to see them. I could never, ever live with myself for one day if I couldn't see my grandsons, Grayson, Braxton, Rowan, or Cole, or my granddaughters, Hannah, and Haley, and Madison. I couldn't live myself one day if I couldn't see them ever or even remember their names. I'm so, so very sad and tragic. But it's sad to put it in this perspective, but it is what it is. When you don't want to even get up out of the ditch, when someone's trying to help you out of the ditch and you still don't want to get out, you just have to lay in the ditch. You just lay there until it's time to print your obituary. Everything else, I mean, there's nothing else left. Nothing else left, brothers. I had hoped that something better would come out of all of this, but as you can see, I'm going to try and put on a little music here now. Hopefully that's not too loud. Anyway, that's the end of my rant. And I'm sorry that I was emotional about it, but it is. It's just, so anyway, what we do have here, here over the weekend, I'm going to try to do a video. It won't be a live video. It just will be an edited version. I'm going to do an update on the events for the rest of the month. And this is going to run into June. I didn't see it's going to run into June because I just had so much going on. I just can't keep up. But we'll have some more news events, local events, and some documentary and commentary. The main perspective here that I've got to get ready before homecoming is the DVD memorial tribute to Officer Winham. I have taken several pictures. I'm going to take a lot more pictures. The more pictures, the better. I have pictures of the memorial down at the Luray Ball Field. I have a video of the procession of police vehicles from Manassas, the escort, into Luray. I wish that I had this 4K camera back then, but I had done it with my phone, but it's still pretty good. But the 4K camera would have been better. As well as I have going on the, let's see, Naked Creek Adventures 1992 version. I'm working on that. As well as a video, or actually a historical thing on James Ernest Mace, my grandfather, and his father, James Harvey Mace, from the Civil War era. Lucas Penn's basketball team. From 1993, and an update on, let's see, I have Charles Allen Good video, my late friend, and I think that's about it for now. Well, that one, But there'll be some more events in June, July, and August. Just have to come up with some material, and hopefully I can get it all put together. And these videos will get better and better as we go. But I hope that wasn't too loud where it drowned me out. That would be awful. But now Facebook, I don't think Facebook Live is for OlmazeyTV. I mean, I have the page, but all my videos that have been good, or at least have been pretty clarified, has been from YouTube. I don't think Facebook Live is, I don't think the up to par was, you know. So, anyway, we'll see what happens. Hopefully this will turn out better than the other one. I'm going to end this stream now. We'll be back over the weekend with something else. Perhaps some guitar playing from my grandson. Perhaps something else. I don't know. I don't know. Whatever comes up is what I'll probably do. I'm going to be working on my truck a little bit. Got a honey-do list here I need to try to tighten up on. A lot of stuff going on. A couple little odd jobs. Some side work. Trying to get it all done at the same time is damn nigh impossible. But thank you all for the comments. Thank you all for your support. I look forward to the next video. So hope everyone has a blessed day. Take care, and I'll see you on the next one. God bless.